When dealing with ordinary differential equation problems, one normally looks for unique solutions so that the differential equation must be complemented with some extra conditions, initial, boundary, etc., such that the infinite set of functions associated with the solution of the differential equation is so restricted that only one of these functions satisfies the extra conditions. See, for example, Boyce and De Prima or Coddington and Levinson. This is the standard paradigm in the field of differential equations, where uniqueness has played an outstanding role and has been the concern of many researchers. For example, consider a problem that is defined by the ordinary differential equation of order n in the standard form in the equation. The general solution to this problem is of the form given in this equation, where c1, c2 and cn are arbitrary constants. The sets of functions phi1, phi2, phi n of t is a fundamental system of solution for the corresponding homogeneous equation, and c of t is a particular solution to this problem. This implies that, one, it has infinitely many solutions, which can be characterized by the set of constants c1, c2, cn, and the particular solution c sub p of t. In order to reduce this set of solutions, one can, for example, consider the extra linear set of conditions in this formula, where dj belongs to r for j equal to 1, 2, to s, and x of r ij tij refers to the r ij derivative of xt at tij.
In particular, one can choose the cpt function in this equation to be the solution to the initial problem with the homogeneous conditions indicated, which implies these conditions.
This condition restricts the set of possible solutions, and if adequately chosen, they lead to a unique solution, it is to a particular subset of constants C1, C2, Cn in this equation. However, in practice, users are frequently unable or are not interested in given these conditions with fixed numbers, the Vi constants, and they prefer to define the extra conditions in a more flexible way, for example, providing intervals or ranges. It is worth mentioning that these problems have important applications in practically all fields and do not necessarily lead to uniqueness of solutions. When fixed values Vi for the extra conditions are used, n, the order of the differential equation, independent conditions can be given. Otherwise, the problem may have no solution. However, when ranges replace fixed values, the number of extra conditions can be unlimited. This makes the systems and uniqueness theorems and the methods for obtaining solutions very different from the standard ones. Consequently, new methods are required. The main original contributions of this video are as follows. A. To introduce to our knowledge for the first time the problem of solving ordinary differential equations with range linear conditions as an interesting and useful alternative to the standard practice of fixed conditions. B. To give methods for solving this problem, it is for obtaining the set of all solutions. And C. To explain how the existence of a solution and its uniqueness can be tested. In addition, the proposed methods are illustrated by their application to one practical example. In this paper, we assume that the functional space to which x of t belongs is adequately chosen so that the required regularity conditions hold, and thus our problems are well posed and we can concentrate on the range problem. The video is structured as follows. Next, we introduce the differential equation problem in terms of ranges or intervals. Next, we show how the set of all solutions can be obtained. Later, we discuss the existence and uniqueness problems. Next, an application to beams is described. And finally, some conclusions are given. In the following part, we analyze what happens if we replace the point conditions in our problem by interval conditions. It is, our new problem can be defined by the linear order differential equation indicated and linear conditions of the type indicated in this form, where b lower I and b upper I are the intervals replacing the constant values Vi, and L does not need to equal n. Before dealing with solving the problem indicated, we assume that we have already determined a fundamental system of solutions, phi 1 of t, phi 2 of t, phi n of t, using well-known methods. Since the general solution of this problem is of the indicated form, we must have this equation that you can see here. I'm considering the previous equations and interchanging the sums, we get this result, which is a system of linear inequalities in the CIs. As the general solution of a complete system of linear equations can be written as a particular solution plus a linear space, the general solution of a complete system of linear inequalities is a polyhedron and can be written as a linear space plus an acute cone. A cone C is said to be acute if no vector S belonging to C satisfies that minus S belongs to C, plus a polytope. It is in the form indicated in the equation. In other words, sets of vectors u, v and w exist such that the general solution of the equation can be written as indicated, where the linear space is generated by the set of vectors ui from I, 1, 2 and n. The cone is generated by the set vj for j from 1 to j, and the polytope is generated by the set wk for k equal to 1 to k. Due to the unbounded from below, unbounded character of the corresponding coefficients rho I, pi j and lambda k, these linear space cone and polytope components play an important role in discussing the nature of all possible solutions. The problem of obtaining the sets u, v and w, which depend on the v upper and v lower and v vectors, the Tij matrix and the fundamental system of solutions phi 1, phi 2 and phi n of t is not trivial. Detailed methods for obtaining minimal sets of generators, ui, vj and wk of this polyhedron can be seen in Padberg and in Castillo et al. The main idea of the methodology is as follows. Solving this problem with the conditions indicated is in fact merely a question of solving the system of linear inequalities in which c1, cv, c2 and cn can be written as indicated in these equations, where the artificial variables cn plus 1 and the redundant constraints minus cn plus 1 less or equal to 0 have been added for convenience, and so cn plus 1 must be removed later. The solution of the system indicated is the dual cone C of the cone generated by the vectors, the components of which are the rho coefficients of this system. The standard methods for obtaining this dual cone can be seen in Padberg and in Castillo et al. This dual cone can be written in a standard form. It is as the sum of a linear space plus an acute cone. Once the dual cone has been obtained, cn plus 1 is forced to be 1. In this step, the polytope part of the cone is obtained if some of the linear space and acute cone generators of the dual cone contain a non-negative n plus 1 component. Finally, the artificial n plus 1 component is removed, and the polyhedral set of all solutions of the form indicated is obtained. A detailed example will be given later. Then the set of solutions of the problem with the constraints indicated is given in this equation, where we have these conditions. These equations provide a method for obtaining the set of all solutions of the problem, if they exist. Next, we consider the existence and uniqueness problem. One interesting problem is that of existence and uniqueness of solution to the problem indicated, which leads to the problem of existence and uniqueness of solutions of the system of linear inequalities that has been indicated. To analyze the existing problem, it is if this system is compatible, a solution to the problem exists, one can proceed as follows. First, the system is written in the following form, where we have replaced the real variable ci by the difference of two non-negative variables, c asterisk I and c asterisk it is ci is equal to c asterisk I minus c asterisk 0. The system is compatible if there exists non-negative c asterisk I values such that the system holds. This means that this vector of its independent terms belongs to the cone generated by the columns of this system. It is, if the dot products of H by the generators of the corresponding dual cone are non-positive. To analyze the system program, we proceed as follows. First, the generators of the dual cone of the cone generated by the columns of the coefficient matrix of the system are obtained. Second, the dot products of the vector H by all generators are calculated. Third, if at least one of the dot products is positive, the system is incompatible. Otherwise, it is compatible and the initial problem has a solution. This method for testing the systems of a solution will be illustrated later. The uniqueness problem leads to the uniqueness of a solution of the system indicated, see Castillo et al., so that uniqueness holds if and only if the set of possible C constants degenerates to a point, a polytope with a unique generator. It is, if the polytope is generated by a single vector. Application to the beam problem. Next, we apply the above method to the beam problem. Consider a beam subject to a vertical load P of T. It is well known that the differential equation for the beam is the one indicated in this equation, where x of t is the deflection of the beam at point t, and e and I, which are assumed to be constant, are the Young modulus and the moment of inertia of the cross-section of the beam respectively. To be specific, we let p of t divided by e I equal to minus 100 and L equal to 1. We assume a dimensionless form for the differential equation. Then, the general solution of this equation is of the form indicated here. The particular solution C B of T in this case is the solution of the equation with the boundary conditions indicated here that leads to the particular solution in this expression. If the deflections and rotation of the two ends T equal to 0 and T equal to 1 of the beam are bounded, say by minus 1 and 1, we have these conditions. And using the previous equations, the following constraints are obtained, as indicated in this equation. To solve this system of inequalities, an artificial unknown C5 equal to 1 is used, so that the two previous systems become as indicated here, the solution of which is the cone in this expression, where V is the matrix whose columns are the vectors V in the expression. Since C5 must be forced to be 1, see the previous equation, it is the pi's coefficients become lambda coefficients, it is the non-negative linear combination in the previous expression becomes a linear convex combination. For the polyhedron to have linear space and acute cone parts, the dual cone must also have linear space and acute parts, and the generators must contain null and non-null last components. Since in this particular case, this cone has no linear space part, and the last components of all its generators are equal to 1, the polyhedron degenerates to a polytope, as it always occurs with bounded problems. Finally, removing the artificial unknown C5, the general solution of the equation with the conditions indicated becomes as it is expressed here. The 16 generator functions, which allow all the corresponding possible solutions to be generated as a polytope, and the associated bounds to be obtained are shown in the upper left corner of the figure, where the particular solution C sub P of T is also shown, the dotted line. This figure illustrates the generators of the polytope vertices, that is, all solutions for deflections, protection, bending moments, and shear forces. The remaining plots correspond to the first, second, and third derivatives, which correspond to rotations, upper right plot, bending moments, lower left plot, and shear forces, lower right plot. Note that from a practical point of view, these derivatives of x of t are more relevant than the deflection x of t, because they allow us to define the steel reinforcement in the case of concrete beams and the checking of its strength for steel beams. If an extra constraint is added, consisting of limiting to minus 1.2 the deflection of the beam as at t equal to 1/2, it is the problem 20 with the problem and previous with the conditions, and x 1/2 larger or equal minus 1.2 is all. Figure 2 shows the 21 generators of the new polytope of solutions and the particular solution Cp of t dotted line. It illustrates the 21 generators of the polytope of all solutions and a particular case dotted line if the deflection of the beam at t equal to 1/2 is limited to -1.2. Finally, figure 3 shows the resulting 14 generator functions if the shear force at t equal to 0 is limited to 50 and interaction constraint at t equal to 1/2 is moving. If the shear force at t equal to 0 is limited to 50. In the figure, we illustrate the 14 generators of the polytope of all solution at a particular case. Finally, figure 3 shows the resulting 14 generator functions if the shear force at t equal to 0 is limited to 50. And the deflection constraint at t equal to 1/2 is removed. It is those associated with the problem indicated previously, and this condition. In the figure we illustrate the 14 generators of the polytope of all solutions and a particular case dot line for the deflection, rotation, bending moments and shear forces. If the shear force at t equal to 0 is limited to 50. Next we deal with the existence of solution problem. To illustrate how the systems method described in the previous section can be applied, two cases of parameterized constraints such as those previously used and the conditions for the existence of a solution are determined. Case 1. Consider the following set of constraints indicated here. In this case, the system becomes as it is indicated here, which, using the technique explained in previous section, leads to these equations, which are the well-known and obvious conditions for existence of solution. Case 2. If the constraint x 1/2 larger or equal to a is added to the constraints, the existing conditions become, as before, together with this equation, which is a symbolic expression. Since a equal to -1.2 and b upper sub I equal to minus b lower sub I equal to 1, in our second example, the system conditions are satisfied. Case 3. If condition the third derivative of x at 0 less or equal to q is added to the previous conditions, the system conditions become as indicated, together with the symbolic constraint in this equation. Since q equal to 50 and b upper sub I equal to minus b lower sub y equal to 1, in our third example, the system conditions are satisfied. Note that for large enough q, condition holds, and then these conditions are equivalent to conditions. Conclusions. In this video, we have introduced for the first time the problem of differential equations with range constraints, and justified how important it is in practical applications. Within the context of solving ordinary differential equations with range constraints, we have introduced in this paper a general method for the following applications. First, testing the systems of solution, which is, in fact, merely a question of finding the generators of the dual cone of a cone, calculating some dot products and checking that they are non-positive. In addition, the method makes it possible to use a parametric treatment, it is, the set of symbolic constraints that the initial or boundary values must satisfy for the problem to have a solution can be easily obtained. Second, obtaining the set of all solutions of an ordinary differential equation, the conditions of which are given not by point values but as ranges. Third, determining whether or not the problem has a unique solution. Four, all the proposed methods reduce the initial problem to a system of linear inequalities, which is treated, discussed its existence and uniqueness of solutions, and solved using existing methods. Finally, the method has been illustrated by its application to the beam problem, as an example of the many possible applications of the range constraints case in different fields of science and technology. Next, we include some references.